Well, hello everybody, and welcome to the Grace Point Noon Devotion. I am thrilled to be with you today. It's Thursday, isn't it? How about that? The weekend is coming. I'm always excited about the weekend as well. But really, right now, I'm just glad to be with you. Got something on my heart today that I want to share with you. That we've been talking about these things, but I think today is really going to help you. Get your grip on something that's going to help you love God so much better. You know, we keep talking about this whole aspect of love God, love people, change the world, right? We've been talking about loving God the last 3 weeks. This weekend, on Sunday, we're going to change to loving people. But, you know, you're going to hear so much about that. But let me just kind of give you one more thing to think about on this loving God with all of your heart. You know, we talk about love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, with all of your mind, and with all of your strength, right? We've been talking about that. We've been talking about those distractions that keep us from loving God with all of our heart. And we looked at 1 John where it talks about, you know, we shouldn't love the world or the things of this world, but because when we do that, the love of the Father is not in us. And so when we read in 1 John chapter 2, we find that there are these three arch enemies to us loving God well. And it's the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. Well, whenever we think about those things, there's certain things in my mind that come up, but it's this lust of the eyes that's kind of got my attention today. It certainly can be one of those distractions that keeps us from loving God with all of our hearts. Because whenever I think about the lust of the eyes, that has to do with my possessions. All the things that I think I just have to have. And sometimes we live, you know, of course we do. We live here in America and we're bombarded with the materialistic world. And it's so easy for us to get materialistic, and the love of our heart becomes the love of things. We live in this world, and there's certainly nothing wrong with having things. There's nothing wrong with having a new car. Nothing wrong with having a nice home. All of these things that can vie for our attention. Nothing wrong with those things until we allow those things to be distractions for us for loving the Lord our God with all of our heart. And so what came to my mind today when I was thinking about this, how can we clear our mind? How can we clear the eyes even on what we see and what we feel like that we have to have? Well, it reminds me of the Apostle Paul in Philippians chapter 4. And there's this very famous verse in there, Philippians 4:13, where he says, "I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me." Everybody knows that verse, right? But oftentimes we don't even know the context of the verse. But the context of the verse tells us that he has subdued the lust of the eyes in his life. How do I know that? Well, let me just read it to you, if you don't mind. It's in Philippians chapter 4, and it starts in verse 10. I'm going to kind of look away for just a second. You know, I should have these things memorized, shouldn't I? But I'm just going to read it to you. Philippians chapter 4, verse 10 says, "I greatly rejoice in the Lord that at last you have renewed your concern for me. Indeed, you have been concerned, but you had no opportunity to show it." And he says, "I am not saying this because I am in need. No, for I have learned to be content, whatever the circumstances. I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. And I have learned the secret of being content." I just love that. "I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether I am well fed or hungry, whether I am living in plenty or I just don't have enough. I can do everything. I can do all things through Christ who gives me the strength." And so what I find fascinating about that passage is that line in there, "I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation." And so there were times that Paul had plenty, times when Paul had a lot. There were times evidently where it says he didn't. He just didn't have enough. But he learned that secret of being content. And so I couple that with this whole aspect of the things of this world that vie for our attention. And we tend to think, if we're not careful, even as believers, we tend to think that we just don't have enough, that we never have enough. Someone always has a nicer home than we do. Someone always has a nicer car than we do. Someone even has nicer clothes than we do. Someone's making all of their budget work perfectly. And for some reason, we're just not getting on top of these things. And so we lose that purity in our heart of loving the Lord our God with all of our heart. And it's simply because we've never learned the secret to being content. And so whenever you think about your life today and you think about where you're at, I mean, have you learned? Have you learned how to be content with what God has given you? Everything we have in life comes from Him. My goodness, I mean, I'm just kind of rambling a little bit, but look in James chapter 1 where it says, everything we have comes from the Father of heavenly lights. He is a God of blessing. And so take a look at your life. Take a look at even the things of your life and the things that you have in your life. And then just ask yourself, you know, have I learned the secret of contentment like Paul had? I mean, can I say along with Paul, I mean, that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me? Can I really say that about the things that I have and don't have? Can I say I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me in regards to my possessions, in regards to what I have to work on with the lust of my eyes? Can I say that? And so I think that's a good heart check for us, and it helps us to love the Lord our God with all of our heart whenever we're honest with ourselves and we're honest with just the whole aspect of where we're at and how these things sometimes can grip us. So another thing I would just ask you to do today that I think would be good for any of us is just, you know, I want to ask you to ask yourself, what am I thankful for? Yeah, I'm struggling with contentment, Lord, but let me focus on what I do have and what you have provided for me. And the more thankful we are, even if we don't have everything that we think we need to have, the more thankful we are for the things that we do have, the more we find contentment in our lives. And guess what? The more we love the Lord our God with all of our hearts. Wow. That's a soul-searching thought today, and I hope it encourages you. And so just ask yourself those questions. Let God be God in your life. Rejoice and celebrate all that God has done in your life, and always carry just the attitude of gratitude. All right, let's learn the secret of being content together. How about if I pray for you? You mind if we do that? All right, let's do it. Heavenly Father, we just want to say that we love you, Lord, and we thank you so, so much for your goodness in our lives and for how you have provided in our lives. And God, yes, we can look around in this materialistic world and we can see that we don't have everything that everybody else seems to always have. But Lord, we have enough. We have enough. And we want to learn the secret of being content, just like Paul did. I think if we ask Paul about his life, he would say, look, I've always had enough. Because his one true desire was to love you, Lord. And really, I know that in all of us, that's our one true desire as well, to love you with all of our hearts. But yes, there are these distractions that we sometimes have to deal with. So God, help us to deal with them well and have a pure heart, a pure and undivided devotion to loving you well. So it's our desire today to love you with all of our heart, with all of our soul, with all of our mind, and with all of our strength. Help us this very moment to do just that. We love you, Lord, and we praise you. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, all right then. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope today's message has been an encouragement to you. And if it's been an encouragement to you, then maybe you want to share that same message with somebody else. Forward it along or whatever you do. But here's the deal. God bless you. I love you. And I hope to see you soon, whether you're in the house or you're in your house, tuning in with us on Sundays or whatever. We are just so glad you're a part of our Grace Point family. God bless you. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.